I'm Olivia.
And I'm Eli.
And this is SNBN.
And that's Welcome. So our season's going good so far. We're 13-1 right now, and I think we can go pretty far when it comes to districts and then state.
I think our season's going pretty well. Right now we're 11-1, and hopefully tonight we make it 12-1. And I think we can make it a long ways because we have a good pitching staff, and Drew DeWayne's a bot.
The baseball season's going really good. We're on a 12-game win streak and hoping to extend it, and we're doing really good as a team. We're all getting along and everything's going our way.
All right. Our season's been pretty good. Probably, honestly, one of the best in a while. It's looking good. A lot of good players, good team chemistry. A lot of fun, mainly.
All right, so I think our season's going pretty good right now. And so we're taking it game by game. So we're trying to go 1-0 every week. And I think that we have a pretty good squad this year to go pretty far. But for now, we're just taking it game by game to keep doing what we're doing.
All right, what do people need to do tomorrow, Friday, and Saturday, Maya?
Well, come to the play because we've done some hard work for it.
Yeah, we have.
All right.
Come see this play about the Holocaust. It's going to be really good.
It's going to be serious, but it's going to be a good time, educational, not fun because it's about the Holocaust.
But it's fine. No, it's great. It's good story, good times.
Come support your theater department. It's going to be great.
Yeah, do it.
All right, thank you.
Thanks.
Now on to
Micah versus Geese.
Question of the
week.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be a famous. Or if I can't be a famous, I want to be a concert photographer. Or if I can't be a concert photographer, I want to be an artist manager so I can manage artists like Nicki Minaj.
Mister.
Sir.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
An assassin.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
Engineer.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
Homeless.
B-Man, what'd you say?
Yeah, I don't know. Probably a fireman.
His mom posts Facebook about it.
Jet, what do you want to be when you grow up?
Rock star.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
Oh, what do I want to be when I grow up? I have no idea. I'm not grown up yet.
Hey, what do you want to be when you grow up?
Fireman.
That's a good one.
If I could sing the George Strait song, They Call Me the Fireman, I would, but I can't sing very well.
And you're not a fireman.
And I don't like being recorded when I don't know about it.
Hey, looky there.
Now on to senior quotes.
Stop caring what people think. High school goes by too fast.
High school's better when I'm dancing.
D is for diploma.
Set your expectations low and you'll never be disappointed.
In a world where no one is absolute, be absolute.
If you do the same thing as everybody else and act like everybody else, you're being someone else.
On to the teachers. With... You gotta do it. Did you
Old
do it
Town
right?
Road.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached. Head is matted black, got the bushes black to match.
Western.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road.
I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road.
We're gonna ride till we can't no more.
I got the horses in the back.
Horse tack is attached.
Hat is matte black.
Got the boots just black to match.
Riding on a horse.
Hop. You can whip your Porsche.
I've been in the valley.
You ain't gonna bump that porch now.
Can nobody tell me nothing?
You can't tell me nothing.
Can't nobody tell me nothing.
Can't tell me nothing.
Like that?
Yeah, like.
Horses in the back. I got the horses in the back.
To the point.
With Portoneer.
Hey SHS, we're here to the point with Portoneer. So Ms. Portoneer, how do you think student parking can be bettered?
This is something that's been a topic of conversation lately, mainly because as we get closer to the end of the year, no offense seniors and upperclassmen, you tend to get a little braver in that you, or lax, I guess, and that you don't feel that you necessarily have to do everything straight by the book. And Kathy has been calling students in and having them move vehicles. I really think that if you just, when you go to park, you think, would I park this way on a city street? Mm-hmm. Would I park this way in a public parking space? Because that's what this is. That's the school is, especially along the road that runs by the baseball field and the soccer field. That's parallel parking only. Keep that in mind.
Right, right.
And we also, when you park, you got to make sure and think about, could somebody fit through if you're on the ends? So
right.
If you're extending those rows, then you're blocking traffic and you're more than likely to get sideswiped, whatever it might be. And if you're not in a parking spot, then nothing can be done about it. So legally, it actually says in one of our handbooks for parking privileges is that we can have you guys towed. We don't do that. I don't want to do that. I mean,
you'd rather have them move.
I would much rather just call you down and have you move. But if we have to do that more than once, there'll be disciplinary action. And we've
right.
talked, and I've had that conversation with those that have had been asked to move more than once. So just make sure you're not pushing it too far and that you're following those rules. It's a safety thing.
Okay. And also another question for you is, this year's play is historicals. How do you feel about doing a play here that has historical background?
I think it's fantastic. And actually, can you tell me a little bit more about the play?
Yeah, the play is in the Holocaust. It's in a Jewish ghetto, cross between a Jewish ghetto and a concentration camp called Terezin. And people are getting shipped off to Auschwitz. This place is basically a waiting game for them to see if they're going to let them stay there or ship them off to basically be killed. So it's very real. It's about, revolves around the story of a girl named Raiha, mm-hmm. and me and another girl, Maya Silkip. Maya plays the younger version, I play the older version. I'm telling the story as she's in it.
She's acting through it.
Uh-huh.
Nice. I can't wait to see it, first and foremost. I'm so excited. And I can't wait for our students to see it. I think it's great that it has an educational base. And I will tell you, I have had teachers ask about extra credit when given an educational assignment to it. And just so you guys know, that my decision was that no extra credit can be given for attendance to the play, even with an educational assignment attached to it. And I want the student body to know why that decision was made as well. The teachers know, but I want you guys to know. Our grades should portray our learning, our knowledge, and our mastery of standards and concepts. And when we offer extra credit for things that aren't tied to those, then our grades don't portray what they should. Also, I am all about equity, very much so. And in order to do those assignments and even the added educational piece of it, you still have to buy a ticket. And I know Ms. Wolves was very understanding and mm-hmm. offered, you know, free tickets if needed.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not comfortable with it. We haven't offered extra credit for other school activities. And so at this point, I've put a no to it because I want it to be fair.
Mm-hmm.
It kind of goes back to that. We don't do extra credit for Kleenexes or,
right.
or the Clorox wipes and that kind of stuff because it's not educationally based and we don't buy grades. So I really hope our students get out and go and attend, and I hope our teachers encourage them to do that. Unfortunately, we just won't have extra credit tied to it. So.
Right. All right, well, I think that's all I need. Thank you.
Hey, thanks for sitting with me and talking today.
Yeah.
This has been
SNBN.